The next is Tencent's ABetterChoice. That's a good name. Tencent's ABetterChoice A/B testing SaaS platform. So Tencent is in the gaming business. They're one of the biggest in terms of revenue, the biggest gaming company in the world. And they have a really robust A/B testing framework, internal framework, right? And they try to, so this is a story of them trying to transform that internal platform into a SaaS offering that's going to help more gaming companies, right? The A/B testing. And that comes with a lot of challenges. So the first, the internal system is really data warehouse dependent. So it uses a lot of data warehouse for acceleration, right? And also it has limited support for join queries. So they had to do a lot of denormalization, right? And then going SaaS, right? So they have to handle a multi-cloud environment and needs to support multiple open lake formats, right? And the fourth challenge is from cost. So A/B test collects a lot of data, a lot of user behavioral data, and that can blow up storage really fast. If they're doing for themselves, that's probably controllable, but serving that to external clients, other companies, and that cost can blow up really fast. Let's see how they address this issue. So the implementation is two parts, right? So first, they use the Tencent big data service internally, their big data cloud for their internal use case, and a Databricks-based data lakehouse, right, on multiple clouds, including Azure, AWS, and Google Cloud. And they have a unified query layer that's based on StarRocks, right? And the result of that is a pretty simple architecture that both serve internal users and external customers, right? And also by unifying all of the queries with one query engine, right? SQL is unified. So their application can reuse a lot of the SQL script for their applications, right? And also StarRocks can do joins really well. So they significantly reduced the number of denormalization they need to do when they compare to they were using a data warehouse internally, right? And also storage cost is reduced because less denormalization, and also cloud object storage is much more cost effective.